I'm Ruzan Kambada, and I'm a serial entrepreneur, and I started my business from scratch, that is with a zero capital, and thanks to technology I could do it. We are into IT domain, into softwares, into cloud computing, into augmented reality, and we were also into broadband. We were the first ISP internet service provider for the state of Gujarat in broadband when the broadband license opened up. And that broadband was, in simple terms, people didn't even know what broadband was in Gujarat or in India at that time. So we used to educate them, telling them that it's internet via cable. So this was the level of education we had to do. I started my careers with websites, and again, it was around 15 years back. And again, people didn't know what websites were, or what they would ask me, what is the difference between a website and a web page? So I used to, the simple way, you know, we have been taught that make it simple. So in simple way, I used to explain that web page is that you are living in an apartment or a flat, and website is that you are having your own bungalow. So this is the level, why I'm explaining that, this is the level of understanding which you have to go to them. And thanks to technology, I'm into a lot of technological related businesses. Thanks to mobile telephony and the way smartphones have come up, people are now a little bit comfortable with technology. They may not know how to use, like my mom, she doesn't know how to use the computer, but she sees TV serials on mobile, and she sends mails on mobile, but if I tell her to send it through computer, she's not comfortable. So thanks to mobile, this thing, technology has become quite near. Secondly, government did understand that broadband is an enabler, or it helps up to spur up the economy. So we don't have that good number of broadband connections in comparison to mobile, but yes, we have good broadband connections. And what they did, they have seen that broadband connections reach till rural till the end village. So, and we have a lot of e-governance projects wherein the villagers or everybody gets a lot of data. A lot of things are now done online, which also helps to stop somewhat of corruption, and there's a lot of transparency. So, in fact, technology has helped a great deal. Coming back to my business, that how it helped, the biggest challenge for me was, obviously, we were in a new field, so we had to go and explain to people. But people didn't understand it, because as a businessman does understand. Maybe a lot of people say that, businessmen say that buying a computer is like an expense, but other businessmen understand that it is an investment. And a lot of people didn't know that, and we were lucky to find such business people. I faced particularly was that being a young CEO, because usually a CEO is supposed to be a old person, 50 plus. So being a young female and going and talking about technology, so they would be zapped that a young person is a CEO of a company. But that obviously slowly we could overcome that. We had to build up confidence in them, and we had to prove them that how technology works and how it can be helpful. So otherwise, I don't think so. People were open. Yeah. Secondly, what we did, India is a country where you look out for return on investment. So we could show them that this is how you're going to get your investment back, or how it is going to help you in your productivity and efficiency. So, you know, when we used all these things, my customers are very happy. And I'm very proud to say that today I still have customers which are 18 years old, who were with me when I started my business. So that's a very, very good thing. I'm coming from a business family, so my father is a big businessman, so he's my point of inspiration. The point is that when I was young, I used to go to his factory when in my vacations. So I learned a lot of things on the ground floor, or on the factory floor. He taught me one thing, that if you want to come up in life, you have to, one thing he taught me is simple living and high thinking. Second, he taught me that if you want to come up in life, you cannot sit in your AC cabins. That won't help you. You have to go on the ground floor or the workshop and work. So today also, I would attribute my success to the reason that whatever I do, whatever products I create, whatever businesses I do, the first thing I do is I take my product, develop it a little, go to the customer, speak to the customers, change it according to their requirements, and then sell them. That is how all my products have been successful. Secondly, what he taught was knowledge is power. So as I mentioned in the first aspect, that I started my business from scratch. I did not say, okay, let me put in X amount of money and then only I'll start my business. I said, no, let us work through our knowledge. And IT is such a field wherein it is very easy. So this was the second thing he taught me. Third very interesting thing, or a very important thing which I learned, was failure is fertilizer to success. He has always inspired or put into me that never be afraid of failure, which I find a lot of people here, if they fail, what? He always said that don't be afraid of failure. If you fail, it is good because you are going to learn from it. Because if you succeed at the very first moment, then if you fall down after the next time, you would not be able to handle yourself. But if you take step by step, fail and then take a step, fail and then take a step, then it's helpful. So failure, thanks to him, these were all the things which helped me to become a good entrepreneur.